Hello. So, today I thought it might be a good idea to look a little bit at something with a lot of greenery in the foreground and not so much in the back. If you could see the house in the background. One of them is done in purple pencil. One of them looks like it's done in green watercolor. Now, the interesting thing about the watercolors, also come in pencil form. So this is an aquarelle. This is an aquarelle light blue pencil. Now it has a nice. It does have a tinge of a yellow here, and it is a moon-kissed night. Nevertheless, I'm gonna. There are some birds over here. So perhaps at twilight, and I'm just gonna show you that I'm using a little of the light blue aquamorel, actually aquarelle. Back here. So that we have our birds. In a light blue sky. Now this pencil goes on nicely, you know, has a good texture on this bond paper. But my reason for showing you the let me just outline a little bit the birds a little better so that maybe we could make them a little more visible. And I realize that you know they're off in the up in the sky and kind of far away. It's not a foreground, it's not a big portrait or thing. But I just want to give you an idea of how much fun and how easy it is to use the aquarelles. Then after you put on a little pencil, if you wanted to give it a painterly effect, you simply go over the aquarelle because it is a watercolor. And of course, you got aquarelle orange. You want to do some flowers over here. And I'll just give the flowers some stems. This came out very light, but I just want to give you an idea of going over what you may have done with pencil with a paintbrush. And if you could see the birds are sort of like in front of a light blue cloud now, and that's my aquarelle. Now the dog here, there are some other flowers and there are some other flowers in the foreground. If you could see near the dog, those were done in like a regular blue pencil. I mean a regular lavenderish, purplish pencil. The dog is done in a regular brown pencils. So, this one is a little larger. This is our computer, and this not being aquarelle, this is our poster paint. And actually, I'm gonna just do some of these leaves. I'm even gonna do a larger leaf here, and I'm gonna add a plant in between coming out of our computer. Because it's kind of fun to use these poster paints, and it's just in general fun to use mixed media. So if our computer is sketched in pencil and it has a lot of plants, it has a lot of plants around it, and now I'm just adding another plant in order to give the picture a little more life. It was sketched down in pencil a while back, and I could just add some more green here. And I do actually have an aquarelle grass green, and I'm gonna just outline the foliage, give more stem, and I'm gonna use the grass as a base, a grass green as a base. Color in one of the older leaves from the plant that was already here. Alright. So here's a Tyrannosaurus I was doing last night. And his body as well I was doing with the green aquarelle, and I hadn't touched it yet with the water. And there's foliage there, and he's eating a clump of greens there. And this I did, actually, last night. I started doing this last night. It was the Now, these are fun to do. These are just like, if you get into a creative mood or you're just sketching around, these are like collage-like pieces where I use the orange aquarelle. If you look on your left, on the left upper, that's orange aquarelle where I did these little vase-like things. And then I did some vase-like things next to it. Crayon. Now, up above, top piece, there's a figure there. And that was actually, see the fellow there with his arms extended, black watercolor. And I have a tendency to use watercolor like that when I want to do little figures. So I just did these little pieces on these little pieces of paper, on the lighter paper, not on the pink paper, and I just actually glued them onto the pink paper. And that is actually a kind of plant down there. See the three flowers? And actually the orange aquarelle work very nicely. Has very vibrant, nice orange, and it's nice with the pink background. If I turn it over, I have four different bowls and vase pieces. On the bottom, I have like a peach, a large pink peach. See the peach? So these are collage, and the creativity comes out on these little pieces of paper. And then I just glued them up. And I have made greeting cards out of these kinds of things. If you have access to a color copier and you color, you get the pink background, and it's just comes out nice on a photocopy machine. The copies, you would just cut off, could use the whole sheet if you wanted to make a big greeting card, but if you wanted to make little ones, you just slice them and slice this whole page in thirds, and then you would just fold it the other way. On a larger scale, I did the same idea with my little pieces of paper where I got this animal. A lot of crayon. On the back, I have my vases. And if you've ever done a piece of pottery, if you've ever held a piece of clay in your hand, then you know how much fun it is to, you know, get into the creation of it. And I have a tendency to feel that way when I'm drawing these kinds of vases, because I have worked with clay. And so I feel like I'm almost doing a little pottery piece. Animals are always fun, especially cartoon animals. Cats and dogs. Now, like I said about the pottery, you just, if you've ever done a piece of pottery, you know, you gotta like work with the clay until you get it First of all, you want to get it to the consistency you like, and then you want to work with it until you get it at the shape you like. And of course, after you get it to the shape you like, you put it in, what are they putting it in, the kiln, K-I-L-N. And after it comes out, you might paint it. You might paint it if you want to go further with this analogy, or if I wanted to go further with the analogy, you might glaze it, right? So here I'm taking my Aquarelle Smyrna Blue, and I'm just going over it. And I mean, you can be as detailed as you want, or as placid. This is actually a color erase pencil, which I'm adding some design. For those of us who like to do people, put him in a striped shirt. And have him like looking at the vase and sort of observing it. Just observing it. Perhaps he just made the vase, and you have to take a step back to see it. I always find these vases a good starting point, and it does take shape as you work with it, you know, and it does get depth, and as you draw with it, it gets mass. I mean, it gives you the a sense of mass to it. This page was entitled Estuary, so I think I have done greeting cards out of this piece, where, you know, depending on the size greeting card you want, you cut accordingly and you fold. So a fellow carrying a large bouquet there, that's always nice on the outside of a greeting card, depending on the occasion. And like I say, it would be folded this way, right? And you wanted to make a small card, so you would cut over here, and you would end up with something like a 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 greeting card. And envelopes are kind of easy to make. An envelope that fits that. Take another piece of bond paper and cut it accordingly, and cut one side a little more so that you can flap over, so you have your envelope. From looking at these, you would think that I don't do that many people, or I don't draw people in my artwork, but actually, if you went through all my artwork, you would see that there's really quite a few people. There's quite a bit, quite a collection of different people and characters that I've done. And a lot of mixed media crayon. You see orange, look like orange crayon, brown crayon, and this looks like it's from a little story I did, Ursula McKenna. Because it says she liked John, and a songbird observed Ursula. And it looked like our fish knew about it. This looked like Ursula McKenna. If I can be of any assistance to you, my name is Fred Goldberg, and I can be reached at 347-628-5420. If I don't always carry the cell phone, so if you get the voicemail, please leave your name and your number, and I will get back to you as soon as I can. If you're a person, or if you'd like to use, if you're a person who likes to use email, juntune2000@yahoo.com, juntune2000@yahoo.com, and just please make it obvious that you're contacting me about artwork that you may have seen a video about. And that way I will respond to your email. I will recognize it. I wish you a great day.